Hi, welcome to my new video. This time I wanted to show you the next part in the series about how I make the Hokkaido in ink illustrations. So this is a project that I started during this year's Inktober. I wanted to do ink only illustrations of Hokkaido because I went with Kana recently to Hokkaido and I wanted to draw all the interesting things that we saw there. And at the same time, I wanted to practice my ink drawing skills because I never actually sat down and practiced doing illustrations only with ink and especially with a brush pen. So not with a fine liner and not with a fountain pen, which I'm used to using, but with a brush pen. So a tool that's completely new for me. And when all the illustrations will be complete, I'll turn this project into a small book or a zine that I'll publish myself, and I want to sell it online. This is only the second video in the series, but I already finished 27 illustrations for the book, so I'm only 4 illustrations from finishing the whole thing, and I'll make some additional illustrations, and I still have to write the text, but I almost finished the main part. So yay, I would like to finish the contents of the book this year. But as some of you might know, we moved recently, so we moved our working space and living space back to Tokyo. We have been living near Enoshima for more than 2 years, so a bit longer than we planned, because the work on my Tokyo at Night book got longer than I expected. But at last we had some free time, so we moved our studio and apartment to Tokyo, so back to center of Tokyo. And some of you might ask why we would move from such a beautiful place like Enoshima with the island and the beaches and the cute Enoden train line back to the center of Tokyo. That's just because we think we have not had a proper chance to properly enjoy the city. When we were still living in Tokyo, I was working in the animation studio and Kana was working in her graphic design studio. So we did not have the control over our time that we have now as two freelance artists. So we think we can explore the city, see things like just go to some exhibitions in time when they are not packed full of people. We can meet people more efficiently than when we were working in the studios, and we had most of the time planned for us. So we are excited. Our new studio is ready for work. We already have everything in place. If you are interested how it looks like, I have a blog post on my blog. Yes, I have a blog where I post more text-based things. Just have a look, I'll link it below. And there is a post there with photos of our new studio. We still have to tweak some details, but we are ready for work, and I was able to recommence working on the Hokkaido in ink illustrations and start to edit some videos. I'm also working on the interview with Kana video, in which she will be answering some of your questions about her project of illustrations about Edo, so old Tokyo. By the way, our moving to Tokyo does not mean that I'll be making another book about Tokyo soon. Of course, our stay in Tokyo should be inspirational for us. This is the goal, so why we came back in the first place. But I have some different ideas and goals and things that I would like to do in my mind already. I'll be talking more about these in an upcoming video, including all the things that I would like to do next year. So you can look forward to this one. Okay, this video turned out to be more update than anything else, and here I'm already at the last step of making this illustration, which includes adding the shadows and textures with a brush. So I'm using here a kind of dry brush technique where I just use a brush with a spread tip, so a tip that I just spread around with my fingers to add the shadows and textures, and then just adding some white details that I couldn't get in with just the black ink. However, I try to avoid this and try to stay as true to the ink as I can. Okay, so that's how the illustration looks like finished, and it will be one of the illustrations in this book, so in Hokkaido in ink. You can already see more details about this book on my website, and you can also register, so sign up for a newsletter and you'll be notified when the book is on sale online. Okay, that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. As always, feel free to comment, share and subscribe, and you can also support me on Patreon. It's your support there that allows me to focus on projects like this one and then sharing it with you. It also allows us to keep our studio and pay the rent for it and buy the computers and stuff that we need for work, so thank you very much again, Patreon supporters. Okay, that's it for this video. See you in the next one. Bye.